Dear friends, welcome to another video. Today we're going to use an Arduino to build a simple menu on a Nokia 5110 LCD display. Let's get started. Hello guys, I am Nick and welcome to Educates TV, a channel that is all about do-it-yourself electronics projects with Arduino, Raspberry Pi, ESP8266 and other popular boards. In this video, we are going to learn how to build our own menus for the popular Nokia 5110 LCD display, in order to make our projects more user-friendly and more capable. Stefan, a friend from Germany, asked for this project, so here it is. This is the project we are going to build. In the display, a simple menu appears and with the help of three buttons I can navigate up or down and select a menu item. Let's select the first option. As you can see, a new UI screen is displayed and by pressing the up and down buttons we can change the contrast of the display. If we press the middle button again, we go back to the main user interface screen. If we now select the second menu item and press the middle button, we can turn the backlight of the display on or off. Lastly, if we navigate to the last menu item, we can reset the settings for the display to the default values. Of course, this is just a demonstration project. You can modify it to build your own more complex menus if you wish. Let's now see how to build this project. The parts needed in order to build this project are the following: an Arduino Uno or any other compatible board, a Nokia 5110 LCD display, three push buttons, a small breadboard and some wires. The cost of the project is very low, it is less than $10. You can find links for all the parts I use in the description of the video below. Let's connect all the parts together. I have placed the display and the buttons on the breadboard like this. First, let's connect all the grounds to the breadboard's negative rail. Then we connect the negative rail of the breadboard to the Arduino ground. Let's first connect the display. The first pin of the display, which is reset, goes to digital pin 3 of the Arduino Uno. The second pin goes to digital pin 4. The third pin goes to digital pin 5. The fourth pin to digital pin 11 and the fifth pin to digital pin 13. The next pin is VCC. We connect VCC to the 3.3 volt output of the Arduino. The next pin is the backlight for the display. Since we want to control it via the software, we connect it to digital pin 7. Now, all we have to do is to connect the push buttons. The left button goes to digital pin 0, the middle button goes to digital pin 1, and lastly, the right button goes to digital pin 2. Please watch the detailed tutorial I have prepared on how to connect a button to Arduino without a resistor by clicking on the card here. Now we are ready to power up the project. As you can see, the project is working fine and the menu is working as expected. Great, let's now see the software side of the project. The code of the project is complex, but I will do my best to explain it. You will get a basic understanding of how the code works, but if you want to fully understand it, you have to make your own menu and see exactly how it works. Let's start. In this project, we used two libraries for the display from Adafruit. You can find links for both in the description of the video. At first, we are going to take a look at the Draw Menu function. This function is responsible for drawing the menu on the display. This function is called every few milliseconds, so if there is a change on the menu, this function is responsible for updating the menu on the screen. There are also two very important global variables, the variable page and the variable menu item. The variable page remembers which UI screen is displayed on the screen. So if the page variable is 1, we are in the main UI screen, and if the variable is 2, we are in the contrast UI screen. The menu item remembers the selected menu item. So if its value is 1, the first menu item is selected, so the draw menu function must draw this menu item as black with white letters. If the menu item is 2, the second menu item is selected, and so on. At first, we initialize the display. In the loop, at first we call the draw menu function to draw the menu on the screen. Then we check every button to see if it is pressed. If one button is pressed, then we take action. For example, if we are on the main UI screen and the first menu item is selected, if we press the right button, the menu item variable increases, and in the next loop, the draw menu function will draw the second menu item as selected. If we now press the middle button, the backlight will be disabled, and in the next loop, the draw menu function will update the display to show that the backlight is off, using the Boolean backlight variable. That's the basic idea behind this menu. We follow the same procedure for all the menu items and pages. It seems complicated, but if you try it yourself, you are going to understand it more easily and you will be able to expand it with more menu items and UI pages. As always, you can find the code of the project in a link in the description below. Now that we know how to build menus for the Nokia 5110 LCD displays, we can add more features to our projects and make them more user-friendly. This simple menu that we built today can be improved though. We could use interrupts instead of checking the button states all the time. This way we can reduce the power consumption of the project and make the code cleaner. I will prepare a video on interrupts soon, so stay tuned. I would love to hear your opinion about this menu project. Do you find it useful and do you plan to use a menu in any of your projects? Please post your thoughts and ideas below. Thank you. If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribe. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel in order to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build.